Okay, those who are attending online, voice is audible. Those who are attending online, voice is audible.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just a minute. Where are remaining students? How many of you are there? Only 8 to 9 were there. But that much students are not there, no, for NSS, because I am having list of only 10 to 11 students. But they were not present there, no? Because I got present yesterday from there. Okay, so see, now into the today's lecture, we will cover another very important point, which is related to our first chapter, that is nothing but the, what can I say, specification, which is used into this design. Okay. So see, yesterday I have already told you what is the requirement of specification, why these specifications are necessary, why it is necessary. See, the two important point why these specifications are necessary. What is the first point? That is nothing but the word to user. It helps to choose a quality of product as per the standards. If specifications are known to us, then what it will going to happen? It is possible for user to choose the quality product. म्हणजे ज्या प्रोडक्टची क्वालिटी चांगली आहे तो प्रोडक्ट चूज करण्यासाठी कुणाला हेल्प होणार आहे? टू द यूजर. ओके. अँड द सेकंड रिझन इज द फॉर अ डिझायनर ऑल्सो इट हेल्प्स इन आयडेंटिफाईंग बेस्ट डिझाईन. ओके, मीन्स इफ द स्पेसिफिकेशन्स आर नोन, देन व्हॉट डिझायनर इज गोइंग टू डू, इट विल गिव अस द बेस्ट डिझाईन विच इज ऍक्सेप्टेबल बाय द यूजर. यस्टरडे आय हॅव गिव्हन यू द एक्झाम्पल ऑफ मोबाईल. Okay, means what? If this particular my handset will going to sold for lot of rupees. Okay, that from that information, what the designer should understand that whatever the specification which is present into that mobile, which is mostly acceptable by this particular, what can I say, user. That's why the specifications are the necessary. Okay, so whatever the design that which we are going to study. Whatever the specifications for each and every machines, means we are going to study the design of 4 machines as far as our syllabus is concerned: transformer, DC machines, induction motor and the synchronous machines. We are having the different specifications for that. Okay, so what, there is a nothing difficulty into that specification, in the sense फक्त आपल्याला डिझाईन करताना कुठला डेटा गरजेचा आहे, दॅट इज नथिंग बट द स्पेसिफिकेशन ऑफ दॅट मशीन. ओके, विथ द हेल्प ऑफ दॅट डिझाईन स्पेसिफिकेशन व्हॉट वी हॅव टू डू, वी हॅव टू सॉल्व द प्रॉब्लेम. बट व्हाय इट इज नेसेसरी? बिकॉज हू केम लास्ट, मेक शुअर दॅट यू क्लोज इट प्रॉपरली. Okay, so what, whenever we are going to design any particular machine, that specification is needed for us. Te aplyala kay garjeche aahe. Okay, see what is important, I am going to tell you in the MCQ specially this specification is going to be asked. Means they will give you as per the this Indian standard, the specifications of the transformer are, and they will give you 4 options. From that 4 option, what you have to do, you have to choose the correct answer. Okay, so as far as the specification is concerned, this is very very important for the MCQ, multiple choice questions. Okay, everybody got it? Why specifications are required? into the design. Why specifications are required? The reason is given here. For the user to choose a good quality product, and for the designer for identifying the good design. Got it? For these two reasons, specifications are important. So we will first of all starts with the transformer, which are the C. Yesterday I have given you one homework. Have you did that? Those who are present yesterday, I have given you one homework that you have to tell me the meaning of this. What is this 2026 stands for and 1960 stands for? Into the yesterday's lecture, those who are present, for them I have given you homework. Have did it? If not, for tomorrow's lecture again, you have to search it. It is not that much difficult. Go to the Google, mention their Indian standards, mention their Indian standard code meaning. You will get that ample information related to that. You have to tell me what is the meaning of this 2060 and what is the meaning of this 1962. Okay. Everybody got this one? Now see, as per as the transformer specification is concerned, see, as per the transformer specification, first of all, we are going to deal with the specifications of transformer. So which are that specifications? See, as per as deciding the specifications of transformer, we are using two Indian standards. Which are the two Indian standards? Here it is specified. Indian standard 2026-1962. Why this is important? Because whatever this, it is going to be asked into the MCQ, multiple choice question. Whenever deciding the specification of transformer, which of the following Indian standard is going to be used? And you are having the four options. From that, you have to choose the correct answer. And another, which is that 1180-1964. Now here, whatever the last word is there, that is clear to you. That 1962 is nothing but the what? 1964. On that particular year, it has been approved by India. That whatever that year is there, that is given. In short, I will tell you. But you have to search this. What is this 1180 and what is this 2626? Everyone got this one? Okay. So what? As far as the MCQs are concerned, these two questions are very, very important. What? MCQ madhe tumhala kay dile janar ahe? आपण ट्रान्सफॉर्मरचे स्पेसिफिकेशन कुठल्या इंडियन स्टँडर्ड नुसार ठरवतो आणि त्याचे तुम्हाला काय करणार आहे फोर ऑप्शन दॅट इज गिव्हन टू यू यू हॅव टू टिक द करेक्ट आन्सर व्हॉट इट एवरीवन सो व्हिच आर द स्पेसिफिकेशन्स ऑफ द ट्रान्सफॉर्मर सी दिस ऑल थिंग्स यू नो दॅट यू हॅव स्टडीड इट इन टू द इलेक्ट्रिकल मशीन वन बट दीज आर कन्सिडर्ड ऍज द स्पेसिफिकेशन while designing this particular transformer. So which is the specification? Manje aplyala pahili kutli information paije? First of all, KVA rating of that particular transformer. Kay mahit paije aplyala? KVA rating of that transformer. Whenever we are going to design, which is required as far as the specification? KVA rating. Then voltage ratio of that particular transformer. Okay, you have studied it into the electrical machine. What is the voltage ratio, turns ratio of that particular transformer? Okay, so what is required? Voltage ratio of that particular transformer. Then current. So which value of current we are requiring? The value of primary current and the value of secondary current. That is nothing but the I1 and I2. You have studied the equivalent circuit of the transformer like this one. Okay, this is nothing but the transformer core. Here that particular turns were present. This is the primary side and here it is also turns were present and load is connected here. Okay, whatever this particular primary side current is there, that is I1, and whatever this current is there, that is nothing but the I2. Have you got it? So what is required there? The value of primary and secondary current. Got it, everyone? So which is the first? KVA rating. Second is nothing but the voltage ratio. Then current, the value of primary and secondary current. Then number of phases in the sense whether it is single phase transformer or whether it is three phase transformer. नंबर ऑफ फेजेस काय गरजेचं आपल्याला, वेदर इट इज सिंगल फेज ट्रान्सफॉर्मर और वेदर इट इज थ्री फेज ट्रान्सफॉर्मर. ओके, सी व्हेन एवर वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी नाउ इन टू द ट्रान्सफॉर्मर द आउटपुट इक्वेशन ऑफ ट्रान्सफॉर्मर. फॉर सिंगल फेज ट्रान्सफॉर्मर द इक्वेशन इज डिफरंट अँड फॉर थ्री फेज ट्रान्सफॉर्मर इक्वेशन इज डिफरंट. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दॅट जर आपल्याला सिंगल फेज आहे का थ्री फेज आहे हे माहित नसेल तर कुठलं आउटपुट इक्वेशन आपण यूज करणार, विच आउटपुट इक्वेशन वी विल गोइंग टू यूज, नो डोंट नो. सो व्हॉट इज रिक्वायर्ड देअर, नंबर ऑफ फेजेस, दॅट इज वेदर इट इज अ सिंगल फेज ट्रान्सफॉर्मर और वेदर इट इज अ थ्री फेज ट्रान्सफॉर्मर. देन फ्रिक्वेन्सी, फ्रिक्वेन्सी एज यू नो दॅट जनरली द फ्रिक्वेन्सी इज ऑफ व्हॉट इंडियन स्टँडर्ड 50 हर्ट्ज. ओके, इफ इट इज नॉट गिवन इन टू द एक्झामिनेशन, इफ इट इज नॉट गिवन इन टू द प्रॉब्लेम, वी हॅव टू अज्युम इट एज द 50 अँड वी हॅव टू सॉल्व द एक्झाम्पल, बिकॉज एज पर अवर इंडियन स्टँडर्ड विच इज अवर स्टँडर्ड फ्रिक्वेन्सी 50 हर्ट्ज. ओके, देन नेक्स्ट इज नथिंग बट द टाइप ऑफ दॅट ट्रान्सफॉर्मर. So which type of transformer means now whenever we will enter into the second chapter we are going to study, our first point is that types of transformer. So whether it is a power transformer or whether it is a distribution transformer. So what is power and distribution transformer, have you know any idea? The transformer which is used at the generating station, that is considered as the power transformer, and the transformer which is used at the distribution station, that is considered as the distribution transformer. Simple is there, nothing difficult. Have you got it? The what is the exactly power transformer or the distribution transformer? The power transformer which is used where? It is used where? Generating station. And distribution transformer, it is used at the distribution station. Okay, then connection of HV winding and LV winding. What that HV stands for? Correct. High voltage winding and LV stands for low voltage winding. Okay, that I will tell you whenever we will study, know how their connections are given, whether it is star or delta like this one. Okay, their connection, how they are connected, whether they are connected in star or delta. Only two types were there. And see, when it will going to appear star and delta? If we are considering the three phase, okay, there itself that star and delta applicable. When we are going to consider the single phase, whether that star and delta is applicable there? No. How you know that? Into the first year, you are having the chapter polyphase circuit. In that polyphase circuit, what we have studied? Star connection and delta connection. Means it is hidden that whenever that transformer is three phase, there should be a connection of star and delta. Star or delta, we can say. Okay, if single phase transformer is there, whether there is a requirement of any star or delta? No, we have to follow the regular procedure. And many of the time, actually, whatever this percentage tapping and percentage impedance, generally for some example or some critical example, it is necessary. That is percentage tapping. Okay, you have already studied 50%, 86.6% tapping into the three-phase transformer. You are having spot connections there. You have studied into the electrical machine one. Now the chapter, I think fifth number chapter is there, spot connection of the transformer. Tappings were there, 86.6%, 50%, 100% tapping. And if there is a lot of tapping, into the our electrical machine lab, their three-phase transformer were there. Go there and see that tappings were given there. Okay, as far as the turns are concerned. Okay, tappings manje todkat kay, what is exactly tappings? How many, if you are having number of turns, tatla kiti percent number of turns apan select karaycha, that is nothing but in what simple way we are saying, it is nothing but the tappings. Okay, manje 56%, 86.6%, 100%. That turns that which we have to use. And as far as percentage impedance concerned, directly its value is given into the examination. 2%, 7%, 8%. And whenever we are studying the output equation of transformer, that this percentage impedance will come there. You have to directly take that value and you have to put that value into the output equation. So these are nothing but the specifications of the transformer. Have you got it? So which are that? What is my first specification? KVA rating of transformer. Then what is my second specification? Voltage ratio. Then third, current, primary value of current and secondary. Then next is the number of phases. Then frequency. Okay. Then type of transformer. As far as the type of transformer, what is that? Power transformer or distribution transformer. Then connection of HV winding and LV winding. And last two point is nothing but the percentage tapping and the percentage impedance. So these are the basic specification we will require whenever we will going to go for the design of this particular transformer. आता ज्यावेळेस आपण क्वेश्चन बघू डिझाईन ऑफ ट्रान्सफॉर्मरचे सॉल्व्ह करू त्यावेळेस हे सगळे पॉईंट तिथे येणारच आहेत. व्हॉट इज दॅट व्होल्टेज रेशो, ह्याची व्हॅल्यू किती आहे, टर्न्स रेशो किती आहे, केव्ही रेटिंग किती आहे ट्रान्सफॉर्मरचं, अँड देन फाइंड आउट दिस व्हॅल्यू. ओके, सो हॅव यू गॉट इट दिस स्पेसिफिकेशन ऑफ द ट्रान्सफॉर्मर एव्हरी वन? विच टू इंडियन स्टँडर्ड वी आर युझिंग फॉर दॅट स्पेसिफिकेशन? विच टू स्टँडर्ड? हा, दीज आर द टू स्टँडर्ड्स as per Indian standard 2026-1962, 1180-1964. These are the two Indian standard that which we are using for the transformer. Got it everyone? Go inside, karega. Okay. Those who are attending online, whether they have got it, which are the Indian which are the standards that which we are using for designing of transformer? Those who are attending online, whether they have got this one? Roll number 39. Ameya, whether you got this? See how many of you are there, how many of you are not there. Okay, so see, as far as design of transformer is concerned, these points are useful. Now we will go for the next, that is nothing but the specification of transformer. After that we are having the another point, that is nothing but the second specifications of the DC machines. Okay, see here, whenever we are going to consider the design, there is no specified, what I can say, word is there DC motor or DC generator. Everybody it is there DC machines, then synchronous machines. Okay, only induction motor, that words are there. Common design is there for a DC machine. Okay, so which standards for the DC machines we are using for the specification? It is given here 4722-1968. These are the standards that which we are using for the DC machines. Okay, so as far as the specifications of the DC machine, very important. First, what is that? Whether it is the DC motor or whether it is the DC generator. Okay, see, it is given here. Whether it is a DC motor or whether it is the DC generator. Apan specification kashache mantle? Machines che. Pan tyacha madhe aplyala kay paije ajun? Which specification is necessary? Whether it is a DC motor or whether it is a DC generator. After that, the output power of that particular machine in terms of what? Kilowatt. What is the output power of that motor or generator in terms of the kilowatt? Kutla unit paije aplyala? Kilowatt. Manje tumhala jar megawatt dila tar tyacha kilowatt madhe tumhala conversion karta yeil ka? It's very simple. ओके, मेगावॅटचं किलो वॅट करायला किंवा किलो फक्त वॅट दिलं त्याचं तुम्हाला किलो वॅट करायला सांगितलं, वेदर इट इज पॉसिबल फॉर यू? बिकॉज दॅट इज क्रिस्टल क्लिअर कॅल्क्युलेशन. आय थिंक नो दॅट मच डिफिकल्टी इज देअर फॉर कॅल्क्युलेटिंग. देन नेक्स्ट, व्हॉट विल बी द इट्स व्होल्टेज, देन करंट. ओके, अँड द व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट इज नथिंग बट द टाईप ऑफ फील्ड एक्सायटेशन. ओके, सेल्फ एक्सायटेड लाईक दॅट वन. Okay, separately excited, that is field excitation, that is very necessary. Because see, as excitation is going to change, design is going to change. Okay, manun tar design specifications important ahe, nahitar specification mahit nasel tar ha take this problem and solve it asa manla tar chalte ka? It is not there. Then what will be the its excitation voltage and current? Excitation voltage, what will be the its excitation voltage? त्याची व्हॅल्यू कशामध्ये असणार आहे? वोल्ट मध्ये आणि करंटची व्हॅल्यू कशामध्ये असणार आहे इन टर्म्स ऑफ एम्पियर अँड देन इट इज नथिंग बट दी इट्स एनक्लोजर टाइप अँड ड्युटी टाइप. ओके आता हे काय ज्यावेळेस आपण डिझाईन बघू डीसी मशीनच त्यावेळेस मी डिरेक्टली सांगतो व्हॉट इज दॅट एनक्लोजर टाइप अँड व्हॉट इज दॅट ड्युटी टाइप बिकॉज व्हॉट देर इज अ डेरिव्हेशन आय कॅन वी इट इज नॉट इन अवर सिलेबस व्हॉट इज इट्स एनक्लोजर टाइप व्हॉट इज इट्स ड्युटी टाइप बट वी हॅव टू सी दॅट बेसिक देन अँड देन ओनली यू कॅन अंडरस्टँड दी व्हॉट इज इट्स एनक्लोजर अँड व्हॉट इज इट्स ड्युटी. ओके so as far as the specification of dc machines are concerned what is required for us first of all whether it is a dc motor or generator that we should know after that its output power in terms of the kilowatt then what is required value of voltage and current but the main important point is that the type of field excitation the type of field excitation and after that excitation voltage and current and the last point hela kshetra udya fakt enclosure type and the duty type whenever we will study that time we will take that point that is nothing but the enclosure type and the duty type. Everyone got this point? There is a difference. Now you can observe the difference of specification into the transformer and the specification of dc machines. Lakshat yete ka same nahi yet ट्रान्सफॉर्मर चे स्पेसिफिकेशन वेगळे आहेत डीसी मशीनचे स्पेसिफिकेशन वेगळे आहेत कारण दोन वेगवेगळ्या मशीन्स आहेत ट्रान्सफॉर्मर इज अ स्टॅटिक डिव्हाइस बट मशीन इज डीसी मशीन इज रोटेटिंग डिव्हाइस दॅट वाय दॅट्स वाय स्पेसिफिकेशन आर द डिफरंट स्पेसिफिकेशन आय गॉट इट विच स्टँडर्ड इंडियन स्टँडर्ड वी आर युझिंग दॅट इज नथिंग बट दी 4722-1968 दीज आर द इंडियन स्टँडर्ड दॅट विच वी आर युझिंग for the specifications of the DC machines. Got it everyone? Now next we will move for the specifications of the induction motor. Okay, now here different points are there but which Indian standard we are using? 4722-1968 this Indian standard we are using for the deciding the specification for the induction motor. So which is the first specifications were there? See, output power. Obviously, it is also there into the DC machine in terms of the kilowatt. Then what is the voltage? Okay, then current value. Obviously, the value of current. But next important point, number of phases. Okay, either it is a single phase induction motor or either it is a three phase induction motor but see as per as our syllabus is concerned we are having the design of only three phase induction motor we are not having the design of single phase induction motor because in the syllabus itself they have mentioned that design name of our chapter is design of three phase induction motor it is particularly specified there that is it is a design of three phase induction motor but previously whenever old syllabus was there that time the design of single phase induction motor was separate chapter and design of three phase induction motor was separate chapter so that's why this specification is going to appear here that is nothing but the number of phases then frequency okay and the very most important part that is required as per as the specifications of that particular induction motor is concerned which is that its connection whether that motor is star connected or delta connected okay lakshat ghya star ani delta he don word jar change zale na tumche purna value change hote it's very important because there is a different relationship of voltage into the star and there is a different relationship of voltage into the delta there is a different relationship of current into the star and there is a different relationship of current into the delta so if connection will going to change your design will going to change okay so this point is also important that is nothing but the star or delta connected machine is there into the directly examination example only they are mentioning that star connected induction motor jyavel star connected induction motor asel त्यावेळेस तुम्हाला त्यातले बेसिक माहित पाहिजे काय माहित पाहिजे व्हॉट इज द रिलेशनशिप ऑफ लाईन व्होल्टेज अँड फेज व्होल्टेज इन द स्टार कनेक्शन ते आपल्याला माहित पाहिजे तिथं ते आपण कधी शिकलोय when we have studied that, when we are into the first year, that time you have studied that. Okay, now that is not part of design. What is it is expected, you should know it. Okay, इथे तुम्हाला काय एक्सपेक्टेड आहे की ते रिलेशन तुम्हाला माहित पाहिजे. स्टार मधलं काय आणि डेल्टा मधलं काय रिलेशनशिप आहे. लाईन व्होल्टेज आणि फेज व्होल्टेज मधलं, लाईन करंट आणि फेज करंट मधलं. ओके, द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज स्पीड ऑफ दॅट पर्टिक्युलर इंडक्शन मोटर. ऑब्विसली इफ इंडक्शन मोटर इज देअर, ऑब्विसली इट इज रोटेटिंग ॲट सम स्पीड, सो स्पीड इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर अस. देन व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट टाईप, दॅट इज नथिंग बट इट्स रोटर टाईप. ओके, वेदर इट इज द स्लिप रिंग रोटर और वेदर इट इज अ केज रोटर. तुम्हाला माहिती आहे वेन एव्हर यू हॅव स्टडीड द थ्री फेज इंडक्शन मोटर, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दॅट इट्स टू टाईप इज देअर, केज रोटर और स्लिप रिंग रोटर. दॅट टाईप शुड बी मेन्शन्ड इन टू द स्पेसिफिकेशन ऑफ द इंडक्शन मोटर. ओके, म्हणजे केज रोटर आहे का स्लिप रिंग इंडक्शन मोटर आहे, त्याच्यावरून आपलं डिझाईन काय होणार आहे, चेंज होणार आहे कसं करणार. ओके, लक्षात घ्या हे स्पेसिफिकेशन समजायला सोपे आहे, पण ज्यावेळेस तुम्ही व्हेनेवर यू आर गोइंग टू ऍक्च्युली इम्प्लिमेंट इट, व्हेनेवर यू आर स्टडी और व्हेनेवर यू आर सॉल्विंग एक्झाम्पल, दॅट टाइम यू हॅव टू रिमाइंड ऑल दिस थिंग्स. ओके, मीन्स वॉट, वेदर इट इज सिंगल फेज और थ्री फेज, देन वॉट इज इट, हाऊ इट इज कनेक्टेड, वेदर इट इज कनेक्टेड इन स्टार और वेदर इट इज कनेक्टेड इन डेल्टा, देन वेदर इट इज स्लिपिंग रोटर और वेदर इट इज अ केज रोटर. ओके, हे पॉइंट्स तुम्हाला काय करावं लागणार आहे, whenever you are going to study design, that time you have to remind it. And the whatever the same, that is enclosure type and the duty type, it is also here. Okay, means if what we can say, rotating machine is there, this two words everywhere it is coming, that is its enclosure type and the duty type. Okay, in our third chapter this point is there, enclosure and duty. Okay, so have you understood what is the specifications of the induction motor? What is the difference into the specification of DC machines and induction motor? What is extra here or what is difference here? Kai difference hai, its connection, absolutely correct, whether it is a star connected or whether it is delta connected. Then its rotor, roper type, whether it is a cage rotor and whether it is a slip ring rotor. Again, what is required there? It is not in our syllabus, but previously into the DC machines, we are thinking that whether it is a DC motor or DC generator, but here it is number of phases, that is whether it is a single phase induction motor or whether it is a three phase induction motor. Got it? The specifications for the induction motor. That difficult asa kai nahi hai. The words tumhala already mahit hai. You know all these things because you have studied it into the whenever you are studying the electrical machines, but these are the specification. Here value aplyala mahit asle shivay apan design karu shaknar nahi. Okay, and the last part, see, related to the synchronous machines, same here. Okay, what is that? First of all, whether it is synchronous motor or synchronous generator, same like a DC machine, what appeared there, whether it is a DC motor or whether it is a DC generator, same concept is applicable here, that whether it is a synchronous motor or whether it is a synchronous generator. Then output power into the kilowatt, it is there in DC machine, it is there in induction motor, and it is there also in synchronous machine. Then voltage is there, current is there, number of phases is there. Okay, then frequency is also there, then connections is also there, whether it is a star connected or whether it is a delta connected. But here the very important point is required for us, that excitation voltage and current, this plays a very important role into the design of synchronous machines. Okay, what is that? The value of excitation voltage and the current. What is the value of excitation voltage and what is the value of excitation current? Okay, everybody got it? And the last is the enclosure type and the duty type, that is everywhere it is into the DC machines, induction motor and the synchronous machine. See, the design of induction motor and the synchronous motor is 50% same. Okay, 50% same. Only what is different? the length of air gap design of induction motor and the length of air gap design for the synchronous machine, that is different. 50% part is same as far as the design of induction motor and the synchronous machines is concerned. Okay, so these are the specification, but as per which standard we are using? 4722-1968. Same standard that is used here. See here, the same standard that is used into the induction motor, 4722-1968, 4722-1968. Okay, and as far as the DC machines is concerned, same there, 4722-1968. Why the same standard appeared here? Can anybody going to tell this answer? Because all things are rotating machines were there. DC machines is also rotating, then induction motor is also rotating machine, and synchronous machines is also rotating machine. That's why we are using same standard, 4722-1968. Got it, everyone? Kaleka, those who are attending online, whether they are getting it, voice is audible, or whether they are not just started mobile and seated there. Kaleka se karna? Okay. So into the open the notebook, give the heading specifications in the design. Okay, those who are attending online, open the notebook, give the heading there, specifications in the design. Okay, so it is given or it is visible on screen. Write down first, specifications of transformer. Specifications of transformer. Specifications of transformer. Into the bracket, write down its Indian standard. It is visible there. Write down Indian standard 20-26-1962. And next, 1180-1964. Written below that, write down the specifications. First, KVA rating. First specification is KVA rating. Second, voltage ratio. Second, voltage ratio. Third, current. Current into the bracket, write down primary and secondary. Into the bracket, write down primary and secondary. Then next, number of phases. Number of phases. Next, frequency. Frequency. Next, type. Type into the bracket, write down power or distribution. Power or distribution. Bracket complete. Next, connections of. Connections of HV and LV winding. Connections of HV and LV winding. Comma. Percentage tapping. Percentage tapping. Comma, percentage impedance. Percentage impedance. Okay, these are the specifications for the transformer. Next, give the next heading. Specifications for DC machines. Specifications for DC machines. okay, mention Indian standard there, 4722 1968. After that, below that, write down first motor or generator. Next, output power in kilowatt. Comma, voltage. Then, comma, current, comma, type of field excitation. Comma, excitation, voltage and current. Comma, enclosure type, and duty type. These are the specifications for DC machines. Next, write down specifications for induction motor. Bracket मध्ये त्याचे इंडियन स्टँडर्ड लिहा. इंडियन स्टँडर्ड 4722 1968. Below that, write down first output power in kilowatt, comma, voltage, comma, current, comma, number of phases. Next, frequency. Next, connections. Connection. Into the bracket, write down star or delta. Next, speed. Next, rotor type. Into the bracket, write down cage or slip ring rotor. And the last, enclosure type and the duty type. The next, specifications of synchronous machine. Write down Indian standard there, 4722 1968. First, below that, motor or generator. Comma, output power in kilowatt. output power in kilowatt. Then comma voltage comma current comma number of phases comma frequency next connection into the bracket write down star or delta next speed from next excitation voltage and current and last enclosure type and the duty type so these are the what specifications okay space this whatever this point is there that is specifications these are very very helpful as far as the MCQs are concerned because you can it means they are having what I can say lot of scope for asking the MCQ म्हणजे ह्यातलं दिलेलं कुठलं बरोबर आहे मग तुम्ही त्याला ऑल ऑफ दिस पण ते विचारू शकतील किंवा एक स्पेसिफिक कुठलं तर दिलं जाईल त्याच्यावरून तुम्हाला त्या पर्टिक्युलर मशीनला कुठलं ते ऍप्लिकेबल आहे ते तुम्हाला त्याला करेक्ट चूज करायचं आहे किंवा जे पर्टिक्युलर कोड दिलेला आहे इंडियन स्टँडर्ड कोड ते पण एमसीक्यूला विचारले जाऊ शकते आता डीसी मशीन ऑर इंडक्शन मोटर ऑर सिंक्रोनस मशीन कोड इज सेम ओनली कोड इज डिफरंट फॉर हुम ओनली फॉर ट्रान्सफॉर्मर because for the all rotating machine code is same no changes there okay so this is related to the specifications of the dc machine sorry you can say all not I can say dc because if they will ask write short note on specifications in the design you have to write all okay tumhala sagla lihayche short note manla ओके पण जनरली तसा क्वेश्चन विचारत नाहीत कारण इन दिस चॅप्टर अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस स्पेसिफिकेशन अनदर इम्पॉर्टंट क्वेश्चन इज ऑल्सो देअर लाईक डिझाईन फॅक्टर लिमिटेशन ऑफ डिझाईन ऑल पॉइंट्स आर देअर ओके सो इन टू दी व्हॉट वी कॅन से इन टू दी टुमॉरो लेक्चर व्हॉट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अ व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट पॉइंट दॅट इज नथिंग बट दी लिमिटेशन्स इन दी डिझाईन आपण काल काय बघितलं व्हॉट वी हॅव सीन यस्टरडे डिझाईन फॅक्टर्स कुठले डिझाईन फॅक्टर्स आहेत बट there as per as the design of any machines are concerned there are some limitations are there jyavelas vegvegle machines che design ahet telat kay some limitations ahet mag kutle ahet baka tenni points dilele ahet je ki apan detail studies karnar ahot saturation then current density okay then temperature next is nothing but the another point is also given insulation next whatever the mechanical strength of that material and next is nothing but the efficiency of that particular motor manje jari apan tharavla ki baba I want to do design like this one but there are some limitations okay means like our same mobile if we have decided we have to want this one but there are some limitations of cost okay if you want high quality high service all things are there into that mobile then obviously your cost is going to increase means what we can say it is nothing but the one of the limitations no for your cost okay if you want all things are good in your mobile camera should be there then its storage capacity should be large its what I can say battery should be having more mAh power then what it obviously your cost of mobile is going to increase means what we can say it is nothing but the limitations of this particular good quality product manje kay te je design che te kay limitations ahet tasa aplyala kuto study karaycha we have to study like into this particular as far as the design of motor is concerned okay those who are attending online, whether they have written all these things, whatever we have covered, लिहून घेतले का सगळ्यांनी? Those who are attended online.
Okay. Yes, sir.